You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Kairim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of our country's diversity. A place of varied traditions and rich cultural diversity, India celebrates a number of different festivals that give out a message of bravery, freedom, and highlight the glorious history of our ancestors. One such festival is that of Bandi Chor Divas, which was recently celebrated in Amritsar city by people of the Sikh community to mark the release of Guru Har Gobind Sahib from the clutches of a Mughal emperor.
Festivals in India are a show of cultural traditions that hold a sacred space in the ancient history of the country, showcasing the culture and traditions of the mighty Sikh community. People in Amritsar city of Punjab gathered together to celebrate the Bandi Chhor Divas, which literally translates to Prisoner Liberation Day.
Shakti itni zaruri hai, jaise bhakti zaruri hai, waise shakti zaruri hai. Aur Guru Gobind Singh Maharaj ne jo sukhon ke andar shakti bhari thi, वो आज नियंग सिंहों के द्वारा हम बिल्कुल अच्छे तरीके से देख सकते हैं और अपने हमारे बच्चों को हम इंस्पायर करने के लिए यहाँ लाए हैं।
Bandi Chhor Divas is celebrated to mark the historical release of the sixth Sikh Guru, Guru Har Gobind, from the Mughal prison along with 52 kings in early 17th century. Like every year, the occasion was marked with a procession which was carried out by Nihang's traditional Sikh warrior order. Nihangs rode horses and elephants during the procession and performed various martial arts by using swords and other weapons. The spectators were left in awe with the stunts and martial arts skills of the performers standing on two and six running horses simultaneously and took pride in the history and example set up by brave Sikh gurus.
Mainu bahut acha laga, ek sach hai. ਕੋਈ ਇਹਦੇ 'ਚ ਉਹ ਫਰੇਬ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ, ਬੜੀ ਸੱਚਾਈ ਹੈ। ਮੈਨੂੰ ਇਹਦੇ 'ਚ ਇਹ ਲੱਗਾ ਕਿ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਸਿੰਘਾਂ ਨੇ ਸੱਚੇ ਸਿੰਘ ਅੰਮ੍ਰਿਤ ਛੱਕ ਕੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਹੈ ਇੰਨੀ ਮਿਹਨਤ ਨਾਲ ਘੋੜਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਇੰਨਾ ਜ਼ੋਰ ਨਾਲ ਭਜਾਉਣਾ, ਇੰਨਾ ਬਲ, ਮਤਲਬ ਇਹ ਬੜੀ ਵੱਡੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਹੈ। ਉਹ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਦੇਖ ਕੇ ਬੜੀ ਖੁਸ਼ੀ ਹੋ ਰਹੀ।
The festival is celebrated after Diwali, which in Sikhism is a symbol of victory of Khalsa.
Having mutual tolerance and regards for each other's beliefs is a characteristic of Indian society. Examples depicting the same can be found across every nook and corner of the country. Recently, the Nizamuddin Dargah in New Delhi became the epitome of communal harmony as it observed the Hindu festival of Diwali. Have a look.
Decorative lights and clay lamps adorn the Dargah of Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia as the country observed Diwali, the Hindu festival of lights. Visited by people of all faiths and communities, the Dargah has been standing as a symbol of love and brotherhood for years. As many Hindus are also devotees of the saint, they lighted up the holy site with lamps. Muslims too help them in the process.
निज़ामुद्दीन औलिया की दरगाह पे ये जो जश्न मनाया जा रहा है, ये खाली एक चीज़ का संदेश दिया जा रहा है कि हिंदू मुस्लिम एक हैं सब, और हम इसको बहुत खुशी से मनाना चाहते हैं और इसका एक प्रतीक ये जाना चाहिए कि हम एक हैं, हम अलग नहीं हैं, हम हिंदुस्तान में हैं तो हम सब एक हैं।
Along with celebrating Diwali, दरगाह also commemorated the 718 उर्स of Hazrat Nizamuddin. Giving a message of religious harmony, a total of 718 clay lamps were lit up inside the Dargah's premises.
उर्स का ये 718वां उर्स है, इसी के लिए हमने 718
118 दिए जलाए हैं हिंदू मुस्लिम एकता के लिए, ये काम हम लोग कर रहे हैं और इसमें जो भी हम लोग के साथ में है वो हिंदू भी है मुस्लिम भी, हम लोग सब मिलजुल के दिया जला रहे हैं और कौमी एकता को लेकर के इस काम को कर रहे हैं।
Well recognized for seeking truth, love and knowledge through a more personal experience with a greater being, Nizamuddin Aulia is respected by the people of all communities. And even today, the way people of different faiths observe their festivals at his shrine clearly states that the lesson of humanity and compassion that was once propagated by the Sufi saint is still having its roots deeply embedded in the Indian culture.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
An Indian fashion designer is using discarded pieces of cloth to piece together fashionable wear for men and women as a sustainable alternative to high fashion. New Delhi-based Kriti Tula's fashion label Doodlage collects fabric waste from factories, discarded for minor defects, and pieces them together to create flowing dresses and saris, selling them for around $100 a piece. Having worked at major textile export houses, the designer said she had seen the environmental cost of high fashion firsthand, waste of cloth and water, and toxins emitted in production process.
When you start processing the fabric, all the pesticides, the chemicals that are used in production of this fabric goes into our waterways, it goes into our ground water. If you look at dyeing processes, extreme amount of chemicals that go back into our waterways, and all of this obviously ends our food chain. If you keep consuming polyester, you wash it at a consumer end, there are microfibers that are always releasing into waterways. So all of this ends up back into our food chain. So everything that we wear eventually, you know, impacts everything that we eat and we consume and we breathe.
Sourcing these scraps initially proved complex and the product prices had to be higher than what many buyers may have felt was worth paying for recycled wear. Gradually, Tula's business has found like-minded vendors and partners, and besides clothes, her label has also started making soft toys, bags, purses and paper out of leftover fabric. Prime Minister Narendra Modi recently unveiled a shrine of revered 8th century Hindu philosopher Adi Shankaracharya in Himalayan state of Uttarakhand. The works of Adi Shankaracharya, one of the most important philosophers in India, was at the front line of the propagation of doctrine of Advaita or non-dualism philosophy in Hinduism. Adi Shankaracharya died near Kedarnath Shrine, dedicated to Hindu god of death and destruction Shiva, and had his memorial built behind the temple at the foot of snow-capped hills. The memorial was, however, destroyed in the 2013's deadly floods. After unveiling the statue, Modi also prayed and meditated in front of it. Modi also performed rituals and prayed at the Kedarnath temple. Hundreds of food items were offered to gods in temples in India's western Gujarat state as devotees celebrated New Year as per Hindu calendar. Bestu Varas is celebrated a day after Diwali, which marks the end of the year for residents of Gujarat. Hundreds of varieties of dishes, sweets, cakes, ice creams, juices and much more were offered in Navsari, Rajkot and Vadodara as priests sang and performed aarti on the occasion.
आज नया साल है और नए साल में एक ऐसे सबकी भावना रहती है कि भगवान कृपा करके बारिश बरसाते हैं और ये बारिश से जो फल फूल सब्जियां अनाज वगैरह जो पकता है तो वो भगवान के प्रति अपना एक श्रद्धा और भगवान के प्रति हमारा उपकार बताने का एक सही तरीका है कि उनमें से बहुत सारी प्रकार के व्यंजन बनाकर भगवान को ये नए साल में भोग के रूप में ये करते हैं।
The New Year Day commemorates Hindu god Krishna lifting the Govardhan hill with his little finger to shelter people from heavy rains. On this day, people dress up in new clothes, decorate their houses with rangolis, a mural made out of colored powders and celebrate with family and friends.
As Hindus in Bihar observe the much-awaited occasion of Chhath with fervor, Muslims in the region too were not behind in contributing to the festival. They were seen making earthen chulas or stoves that are quite significant for the Hindu brethren during the festival. Have a look.
Presenting a wonderful example of communal harmony, around 100 Muslim potters in Bihar's capital, Patna, have been for years preparing earthen stoves for the Hindu festival of Chhath. For many, it is their ancestral work and now they have been carrying forward the legacy of their family. They say Hindus love their stoves and eagerly buy them.
पहले तो बुढ़वा बुढ़िया करते थे, मेरा 20 साल उम्र था, तब बुढ़िया के साथ बनाते थे चूल्हा। अब 20 साल में अब हो गया मेरा 60 बरस, इसमें जुट्ठा कुट्ठा नेम टेम से बनाते हैं, और इसमें हिंदू और मुसलमान के नहीं देखता है कि हाँ कस्टमर नहीं सोचता कि हम ये चूल्हा नहीं लेंगे। मेरा चूल्हा जितना सब बनाता है सब मुस्लिम बनाता है, मगर सब सेल हो जाता है। एक चूल्हा हाजीपुर चल जाता है, समस्तीपुर चल जाता है, बड़ी दूर दूर।
माता पिता भी यही कहते थे, जब से हम होश में आए, जवानी हुआ ना, जब से हम लोग बनाने लगे, बनाने के बाद में हम लोग का चूल्हा हर जगह जाने लगे, पटने नहीं पटना से बाहर भी जाने लगा।
Chhath is considered as one of the most significant and auspicious festivals of northern Bihar and in parts of neighboring Uttar Pradesh and Jharkhand, in which devotees pray to the rising sun for the well-being and prosperity of their children and spouse. Chhati Maiya, regarded as the sister of sun, is worshipped as the goddess of the festival. According to the tradition, devotees prepare prasad and offerings for her on earthen stoves. And as these stoves are quite significant for worshippers, the Muslim potters take immense care of cleanliness for a month while preparing them. They do not even consume meat and fish till the stove is ready.
बहुत बढ़िया साफ सुथरा करते हैं, मिट्टी है, छठ पूजा का पर्व त्योहार का दिन है, जुट्ठे कुट्ठे नहीं को बाल बच्चा के सबके दूर भगल रहते हैं, मीट मछली भी नहीं खा रहे हैं, छठ के बाद खाते हैं।
The way one community is showing its regard for the beliefs of other community not just presents the picture of India's unity in diversity, but also the harmonious coexistence of different faiths.
India is on the move to promote religious tourism. Taking a step ahead, Indian Railways recently unveils the first Sri Ramayana Yatra Deluxe AC Express that will take the passengers across all the iconic places associated with the life and times of Lord Ram. This sacred tour will be in the form of an all-inclusive travel package that will last for 17 days. Have a look.
Retracing the epic journey of Lord Ram, Indian Railways launches its first super luxury Sri Ramayan Yatra train. Earlier it was operated with sleeper class only, but now it is being operated in deluxe AC with many modern features and amenities. The train recently departed from Safdarjung Railway Station in New Delhi and will cover 7 destinations in India related to Lord Ram. It will first stop in Ayodhya before making halts at Varanasi, Prayagraj, Chitrakoot, Nasik, Hampi and Rameshwaram. People can also opt for a package included with Sri Lanka, for which they will have to board a flight from Chennai. It will cover legendary places like Colombo, Kandy and Nuwara Eliya. Running under Swadesh Darshan scheme, which aims to promote and develop the potential of tourism in the country, this Ramayan circuit train is managed by the Indian Railway Catering and Tourism Corporation or IRCTC. It can carry 800 passengers and will roughly cover 7,500 kilometers before returning to Delhi on the 17th day.
ये पर्यटक ट्रेन जो पर्यटन मंत्रालय का स्वदेश दर्शन योजना है उसमें जो डिफरेंट थीम सर्किट्स बनी हुई हैं उसमें एक थीम सर्किट है रामायणा सर्किट, उसको रेल के माध्यम से कवर करने की एक योजना बनाई गई है। तो इस पूरी टूर को नाम दिया गया श्री रामायण यात्रा, और इसमें जो उद्देश्य है कि जो भगवान राम के जीवन से जुड़े हुए जो स्थल हैं उन सारे स्थलों को कवर करते हुए ये एक रेल रूट बना के और पर्यटकों को दिखाया जाए, तो ऐसी ये यात्रा है और ये आज यहाँ से रवाना हुई है। ये 17 दिन के टूर पे रवाना हुई है।
This special tourist train is fully air conditioned and provides accommodation in first and second AC. It is equipped with various features such as modern kitchen, 2 fine dining restaurants, shower cubicles, sensor-based washroom functions and a foot massager. Moreover, CCTV cameras are installed in each coach and security guards are also present inside the train. Passengers were quite excited to enjoy their journey in IRCTC's first super luxury train on the Ramayan circuit.
मैं बहुत ज़्यादा उत्साहित हूँ, और जब से मैंने ये IRCTC टूर के बारे में सुना तभी से मैं प्रयासरत था जाने के लिए, और कुछ भगवान श्री राम ने हम लोगों की सुनी भी और हम लोगों का टिकट भी कंफर्म हो गया, समझे आप, तो हम लोग बहुत उत्साहित हैं।
The Ramayan circuit is one of the 13 circuits being developed by the Government of India under the Swadesh Darshan scheme. Krishna circuit, Buddha circuit and spiritual circuit are the other circuits in the scheme.
At last, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section of World in Focus.
The autumn season has arrived in Japan and the color of trees is changing from green to yellow and red. This is attracting tourists as the beauty around mountains is posing as the most beautiful natural scenery in the world. A large number of tourists in Nikko area of Tochigi Prefecture gathered at this observatory to get a perfect view. It offers a beautiful sight of Lake Suzenji. During autumn, Mount Nantai and the lake view are famous sightseeing spots in Japan. Hacho Dejima on the lake is called Boot because of its shape, and the colorful scenery can be seen from this observatory. The road leading to Lake Suzenji is named Iroha Slope. Many people travel to different spots to get perfect view of the autumn leaves. They even enjoy the nature's beauty while traveling in buses and cars. Nearby the lake, there are several shops and facilities for the visitors.
やっぱり家の中にいるとね、うちあの子供もいるんで、やっぱ家の中ばっかりだとね、運動不足だとかね、ストレスだとか、やっぱ外に来て自然を見るとね、気持ちもすっきりするし、やっぱ心が洗われますね。 私若い頃から山登りが好きだったんですけど、やはりどこ行っても日本はまずまあゴミがないのは当たり前ですけども、まあ四季それぞれいいところがありますよね。まあ春の花も綺麗ですけども、やっぱり秋の紅葉が一番綺麗で、まあ高さ登っていくにつれてだんだん赤が強くなる、黄色が強くなるとね、下に行けば緑がいいと、やっぱそういう色がなんていうんですかね、たくさん色があって、まあ綺麗だというところですかね。
People around the world are praying for the eradication of coronavirus pandemic as the scenic beauty of Japan is waiting for them. After autumn, visitors also can enjoy the beauty of winter. Robots have been dispatched at different venues to help with epidemic screening and control at the Wukesong Stadium in Beijing, where the ice hockey events of the upcoming Beijing 2022 Winter Olympics will take place in February. At a test event held this week in Wukesong Stadium, a robot was used for disinfection. It can spray atomized fog to the ground, sterilizing an area of 36 square meters within just a minute. Another robot is capable of walking up to those who are not wearing masks and tell them to wear one. Experts say the robots can complete the work of volunteers with higher efficiency. Inevitably, in some occasions, people inside the loop will need things like paper documents, personal gear and medical equipment, and robots will do the job to help minimize personal contact. The so-called delivery robots are standing by in the buffer zone. In this area, staff members can put objects on the robots which can load things up to 300 kgs. Tokyo is one of the world's most fascinating and high-tech city with over 12 million population. Recently, it hosted a medical devices and hospital equipment expo called Medical Japan 2021. The latest hospital equipments, nursing care, clinics, pharmacies and infection control products were exhibited. It was the first exhibition organized ever since the coronavirus outbreak. Disinfectants, anti-spray products, hygiene products were put on display as a countermeasure against the coronavirus pandemic. This is a splash prevention panel to protect from COVID-19 virus. The suction device displayed can be used in hospitals, hotels and offices.
パネル一体型の飛沫吸引装置になっております。こちらのアクリルパネルから空気ですとかエアロゾルを吸い込みまして機体の方に流しまして、こちらで UVC を照射することによりウイルスですとか菌を抑制いたします。従来型ですとアクリルパネルの方に飛沫ですとかエアロゾルが乗り越えてしまって反対側の方に落ちてしまうんですけれども、こちらの穴の部分から吸引することによって向こう側に飛沫を飛ばさない目に見えた安心をご提供できる商品になります。
This is a container house for RT-PCR inspection. It is equipped with quick acting unit and a device that cools the temperature using water. The company that develops ventilation facilities in the factory uses this know-how.
発熱ウイルス感染したお客様を病院内に入れなく検査をする部屋と開発させていただきました。実際こういったものはテントとかいろいろ今までもあったんですが、どうしても暑い寒い、それと空気の中で巡回ができてない状態のものが非常に多かったので、当社の換気システムを使いまして空気の流れを作ってあげる、それによって検査する移住者様の安全を守るということで開発させていただきました。
For air cleaning, silver iron and ultraviolet sterilization technology products were also put on display. Medical companies are using their know-how to create effective countermeasures against COVID-19.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host, Skyrim Zimik, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.